Happy, happy Sunday, you lovely people. Well, I'm feeling pretty chilled today. I'm also feeling particularly mellow, and I think today is the perfect day to introduce you to my special guest, Rooster 420. Not only is he from Mexico, not only is he a DJ, but he's also a sound therapist as well. You're going to meet him in a minute. But I think let's just chill and let's just listen to a couple of his videos. Beautiful, absolutely beautiful. You know you're going to meet him in a minute, but you know you've got to be a little bit patient for a little bit longer because we're going to a Jaden Show commercial break. Hey guys, I wanted to take this opportunity to let you know about the Jaden Show commercial break starting now. This is amazing news because now every single week you have a couple of minutes to be able to advertise something you want to advertise. So if you have a business, if you have an event coming up, if you have a new album, a art gallery or anything you want to particularly advertise on a show, this is your chance to do it. March and April 2024, the advertisements are free, so please let me know. Get in touch to me on jadencornelius@aol.com. It will be wonderful to hear from you. If you are a charity or a charitable organization or a nonprofit and you are advertising something with regards to that, then always your advertising is free. So let me know. You will need to send me between a 1 and 2 minute video around that time, if possible, something that you want to advertise, and I will fit it into this spot. Get on. I'll see you soon. Take care. Bye.
Okay, let's do this. Let's go meet this week's special guest, the amazing Rooster 420. Rooster 420, welcome to the Jaden Show. How are you?
Thank you, brother. I'm really very, very well. Thanks for inviting me and thanks for having me on your space.
Absolute pleasure. So for those of you that don't know you, let's go back to when you're little Rooster. How did you, just because you're a DJ, a sound therapist, a sound healer, amongst other therapies that you do as well. Let's go back to Little Rooster. How did your life kind of start to form into what you are today?
Well, I think my first contact with like music or rhythm was when I was a child and I started playing drums, and I really felt like this energy, you know, like this power, like smashing the drums, and then started creating like some, maybe not music at all at the moment, but just feeling it, you know, and I was...
That rhythm and energy, right?
Exactly, brother. Just like feeling it on myself, on every cell of my body, like just empowering myself, feeling this power, like coming from the noise, you know, like from the sounds.
So were you actually playing the drums? I mean, did you get lessons? Was this coming naturally, or was you just smacking the hell out of them?
I think it was the first, at the beginning it was just like smacking. Yeah. And then I got like more deep into like practicing and learning more, and I just went to practice a little bit more and more and more, and then dedicate myself to study and became like better, becoming better and better. And yeah, I found like a big passion on drums, and I think that flows my, like, it guides my path, you know.
Into music, yeah. So yeah. Music was, I mean, you're in Mexico, you're from Mexico originally, I guess.
Yes.
So what music was going around you at the time, at this point?
In the past, when I was a child?
Yeah, kind of like the music your family were listening to. What kind of musical influence did you have at this particular point in your life?
Wow, I think like cumbia at the beginning. I'm originally from Monterrey, and Monterrey is very famous for cumbia music. Okay. And I really like the rhythm, like with the, you know, like, this egg sounds and more like the bass, like
yeah.
And I started like liking it, and I was like, this music has a lot of rhythm, and I mean, all the music has rhythm, but this one in particular and special like makes me feel like dance, you know, and move my body and feeling this like good energy to start my day and achieve my goals and, you know, like pursuing all the things that I have to do during my day and just like put me in a good vibe, you know.
Absolutely. So during school, did they encourage your love of drums and music then?
Not that I'll be honest, like when I was in elementary school, the music class was just the flute, and I was really bad at flute. I was really bad at playing the flute, and I started becoming like a little bit, you know, like shy or uncomfortable in the music classes. But then I realized that flute wasn't not my instrument. And I started like more into the drums, and I really felt it like this is my thing, you know. And then middle school, high school, I started like, I participated in a couple like friends bands, and nothing really big, but I was keep doing it in some way. And I think that was give me the courage, you know, to keep doing it and improving.
Oh, amazing, man. So yeah. you're now kind of getting a little bit kind of, you're into your music, you're growing up, you're in your teens now, and you're kind of starting to feel your way like through school, and then you're deciding, you know, what am I going to do after school? Was you planning on becoming a therapist, a DJ, and a music healer at that point?
Not really, brother, being honest. It just came to me kind of an epiphany, because a story like after college, I just moved to this like more conscious community, which is San Cristobal, and I just surrounded myself with like different kind of healers and therapists in different ways, like with plants, with music, with physical therapists, like different ways to heal our body, to heal ourselves, our minds, our souls. And I just got like, it was a kind of interesting journey, because it wasn't at the beginning like the music column, you know. It was more like the food, and then surrounding myself with nutritious food and like more conscious kind of a more conscious way to eat and heal our body in that way. And then I started surrounding myself with these healers, and then I started finding this sound healers and physical therapists, and I wanted to learn more, you know, to heal the body, to heal our souls, to feeling better in different ways, you know, not just only eating well and taking care of ourselves in that way. But I was more like curious about like, how can I improve my wellness in another ways. And then I found sound healers, I found frequency therapists, I found Reiki healers and this healer community. And I was very interested. I just got like super, super interested. And I was like, man, if I'm feeling this on myself, if I'm improving my lifestyle, my health condition, and expanding my consciousness, what if I learn to do this and share it with other people, you know?
Yeah. So how did DJing get in, when did DJing get involved with your process?
I think I used to own an electronic music bar in Tuxtla like around 6 years ago. And it was really nice, because like basically owning and managing an electronic music bar, club, terrace, I started getting a lot of contact with DJs, like local DJs, national DJs, international DJs, because we used to do a lot of big events, like big parties, and we were hosting these massive events like every 2 weeks, every 2 months, 3 months, basically. And I was like, man, I really enjoy this music. It's really nice, because people dance. It's not too much lyrics on it, but also like people really enjoy it, and it gives you like this sensitive, you know, to feel the music and be more present as well. So I was just like curious, you know, like we go back to the curiosity, because I think that's my most fuel, my biggest fuel, you know, because
it's wanting to know more. That's why I'm wanting to like a sponge, just to get as much information.
Yeah, exactly. I just got inspired because I really enjoyed the music, and I was like, man, same, you know, like same with the sound healing therapy. I got the same feeling, you know. I was like, man, if I really enjoy this a lot, I would love also to be the one providing this this joy, you know, this experience to other people. I would love to be part of this in the other side, you know, not just as a consumer, you know. I want to produce it. Yeah, exactly.
So that's kind of happening for you now, really, isn't it? Because you're DJ, you're probably more known as, do you think you're more known as a DJ now than a sound therapist? Because because you're getting quite nice work offers and you're doing lots of lovely things and lots of plans coming up as your DJ self, right?
Yes. I think I'm more into the sound healing right now than into the DJing project. But maybe once I move, like, things switch a little bit, or maybe I can combine them in the same amount, you know, like 50-50 DJing and providing sound healing, or maybe make a hybrid of this, you know, like,
well, amazing. Wow. A healing club, that would be amazing.
Yeah, bro. Actually, like, there is a guy I just started following, and this guy, it's a Gregorian chant singer. Wow. And he also does like this project as a Gregorian chant singer, and he also does like this Grego techno. It's his project, because he combines basically like the Gregorian chants with techno music.
Wow. And it's, he needs to be on my show, mate.
Yeah, definitely.
So what's going on for you at the moment? What's happening right now for Rooster 420?
Well, I'm planning to move to the south of Mexico, to the Caribbean area, to Tulum, and being more specific. And for me, I think it will be a new adventure. I'm preparing myself to bring few instruments and start with few ceremonies there. I'm talking with my friend who does frequency therapy, and maybe we can combine both talents and provide ceremonies in this way. And I also have a big community in Quintana Roo, in the Caribbean, Mexican Caribbean, who are DJs. So probably I will be hosting DJ sets in the place where I'm going to live and manage. And we are going to put it probably in platforms like TikTok, Instagram, YouTube, just like bringing DJs to our place to stay and feel the experience, you know, like that we will going to provide in this specific place. And it's in the middle of the jungle, so it's not in the touristic area too. And it's really nice that they are going to have the chance to experience this and also to show their projects.
Amazing. That's going to be so cool, man. So how far in advance is this? I mean, this is...
Thank you, brother.
The plan of this is happening right now, but when do you see this actually kind of starting to manifest?
Well, I'm feeling it very deeply in my heart. Probably we are going to start doing this on December or January next year.
Okay, so quite soon.
December this year. Yeah. December this year, maybe January next year. Because basically in Tulum, it's, December it's holidays, and January, basically almost the whole month, it's festival season.
Okay.
So we would love to use this season, high season, to invite as much people as we can. You
know? Absolutely. Wow. Yeah. Perfect. Absolutely perfect. Yeah. So looking way now into the future, what are the plans for Rooster 420?
Well, I would love to keep working. First of all, working on myself, you know, that's the main goal. Keep working on myself and keep improving and developing the skills that I already learned. But also, I would love to move out of the country to expand my consciousness, my consciousness in a way that I would love to learn more about different cultures, other cultures, in special the Asian culture. I'm very interested in that, and I would love to bring what I can give or provide to there, and also learn as much as I can, you know.
Wow, man, that is incredible. Well, where can people find you? Where can people find you on social media?
I'm more active on my Facebook and my Instagram, and now I'm working to develop a channel in YouTube and also an account on TikTok.
Okay, fantastic. So, yeah, I guess once that kind of up and running, you'll be sharing those channels on your other social media channels as well, right?
Yes, exactly.
So if people follow you on Insta and Twitter and
Facebook,
they will find out when your TikTok and your YouTube is up and running.
Absolutely, yes. Yeah.
Bloody amazing. That's perfect. People at home, you've met Rooster420. I suggest before you finish your cheese sandwich and your cup of tea that you go and follow him on his social media platforms. And do you have any of your work available on any other or streaming or download sites? Any of your music or any of your therapy or?
Not at the moment, but I will work and put like some of my sound healing therapies and mindfulness meditations on Spotify. That's what I want to do by the end of this year, or maybe the beginning of the next year, or probably before. We'll see like how things flow. And yeah, I mean, like my work as a DJ, it's more like in parties and events, but I'm working now with a couple of friends, like recording a couple of tracks with the handpan, the steel tongue drum, the steel drum, and doing a little bit of mixing it with a little bit of tropical house and dark techno, like those kind of. Yeah.
Okay, so that's going to be some nice stuff coming onto your YouTube and channels eventually, right? It's already in progress.
Yes, brother.
Amazing. Yeah. Well, mate, thank you so much for being part of my show. I hope you'll come back and chat to me maybe next December, January time when you're into and let me know how everything's going with the kind of, I guess it's like a retreat, like a healing retreat really, isn't it? Yeah, that would be amazing if you could. We'll touch base and we can do another Jaden show then to see how everything's progressing. That would be super cool.
Absolutely, brother. You are more than welcome to join us over there, and we would love to have you there, brother.
That would be amazing. I've just left there to come here. So, yeah, I'm back in January.
Yeah.
We're just doing this.
Yeah, flowing, brother. Just flowing.
What it's all about, mate. That's what it's all about. Rooster420, thank you so much for being part of the Jaden Show. I wish you all luck and success in the universe. And we will catch up soon.
Absolutely, brother. Thank you for having me in your space. And
pleasure.
Thanks for the chance to be here. Thanks for sharing my art. And let's do it, bro. Let's make it happen.
Take care, my friend. Speak to you soon.
You too, brother.
Bye-bye.
Peace, brother.
Well, I hope you enjoyed meeting Caleb, aka Rooster420. And I hope you'll go and find him on his social media platforms as well. Make sure you're already prepared for the minute he launches his TikTok and his YouTube. Go and check this brother out. Go and show him some love and support. I've had a wonderful day. I'm feeling really mellow. I'm going to go and chill now with a nice cup of tea and watch some Gaia television. This is my plan for today. I hope you have a wonderful new week. If you're bored this week, not only are there loads more shows coming up on the Jaden Show, but also I need your help. It will be really great if you want to be part of one of my shows. You can be part of Expats, which is talking to people about their experiences of living in a place that is different to their birth for whatever circumstance. So please get in touch with me. It'd be lovely to hear from you. Or the J-Files, if you've had any paranormal, supernatural, alien or UFO experiences, I want to hear about them. It'll be really great to chat. So get in touch. And also, if you've got any problems that you think we can solve, then there is Air It. So you've got any issues, you've got any things you want to see. This is a bit like a soapbox, really. You can stand on it and you can tell us what you think. And this lovely audience of JCTV will give you a hand in making decisions. That's Air It. So there's 3 shows that you can be part of. Get in touch with me. You take care. Bye-bye.